Okay.
Hi.
We are getting ready to pick up our pilot and go through the Panama Canal. Woo! We've got Miss Peggy B. We've got Daddy up here on the bow. We've got Matthew and David with us, which I don't know where Matthew is. They're downstairs. And we're going to pick up the pilot right now. Miss Peggy Marie, Mama, she will be filming our transit. So we all have important jobs. We're all excited. Should be fun.
Okay, we're getting the ropes ready. We're just waiting for the pilot and we will be on our way. Here comes our pilot.
Going through the canal, we are in line. There's a big Panamax tanker coming through, and we're going in right behind it. All right, we are about to side tie this sailboat back here. This cat is gonna come up and side tie on our side.
Lock. So what's going to happen is when we get inside the lock, they're going to throw me a rope and we're going to tie it into this blue rope over here, and they'll pull us tight against the side. And then the lock will fill up, and then we'll go into the next lock, and then after that it'll fill up and we'll go into the third lock, and then we'll float into the lake. We'll spend the night on the lake and go back, across the lake and go down three locks on the other side, which bring us down to sea level, and then we can float all the way to the Pacific side.
Okay, David and Matthew just got a rope. And they're throwing another one.
Hey, Matthew, bring that out. Matthew, he's gonna come back.
This is amazing. Gates are closing. Gates are closing.
Holy moly.
life-size zincs on there too.
Absolutely incredible.
Big chunks of American steel right there.
It's worth it losing my phone.
Oh, good. Woo! Goodbye, Atlantic. Soon to be hello, Pacific. Do you have anything to say?
We just raised ourselves over 30 feet. The next lock will raise us another 30 feet. And the lock after that will raise us 25 feet, or 27 feet. So we'll end up at like 87 feet.
You guys are walking our ropes up to the next level. Here comes the gates. Okay, we're letting the rope go up so he can hook us on. Look how fast the water is coming in. It's coming in really quick this time. Okay, we're going into the third block. For some reason, this lock has two gates on each side.
Double gates closing for the final lock. All right, I don't know if you see this, but they're pumping the water into the lock right now. We are rising insanely fast. Well, we've made it to the top of the locks and we have a beautiful lighthouse to greet us. Daddy-O is still manning the stern line here. Doing a wonderful job of it. You can see out here the view all the way looking back to the Atlantic Ocean.
We are literally level.
We are right now, 1 mile.
The suspension bridge.
1 mile away.
90 feet above the original ocean.
Yep. We came 1 mile through locks. And we're going to come out here into Lake Gatun. And then we're going to take a mooring ball for the night. And tomorrow go through the other locks. All right. Well, this is day 2 of our Panama Canal crossing. And we are in Lake Gatun, and we've been cruising for about 8 miles now. We're about to come up to the second set of locks.
Where are you?
This is the 7 mile cut that is it's as wide as the intercoastal waterways in Fort Lauderdale. And big, huge tankers go down it right next to you. It's kind of crazy.
Like that big one come at us right now.
Yep. Up behind this red tanker in front of us is the actual lock we're going to be going through.
Okay. We got him side tied onto us. And now we're getting ready to head on into the first lock. We're pros now. Here we go again. We're pretty high right now. As you go through with us, you'll see that we're gonna start dropping 85 feet in total.
Okay, what we got here is we are in the top lock on the Pacific side, and we are gonna drop going through three locks, 30 feet at a time, to right around 87 feet. And that'll make us level with the Pacific Ocean. This will dump out in the Balboa Yacht Club Peninsula lock, and it'll be equal with the Pacific Ocean. Now, if you see behind us, we've got this huge tanker coming in. This lock is about 1,000 feet long. This tanker is probably 700 feet long as it's coming in. You notice there's a tugboat there. They're going to open this gate that they closed earlier, and he's going to come right up to the back of us. This will be pretty incredible. All right, as you can see, the four tractors that are pulling the boat in, the huge tanker, are moving very slowly on the left and right-hand side. There's two of them on either side. He's probably 500 feet from us right now, and will literally be right up against us in a couple of minutes.
All right, and here we go. We're going down. Rick here is letting our stern line out. Watch, I'm gonna go turn. We are in the very front of the lock. So as you can see, here's the door right in front of us. Matthew's holding and letting out on our bow line here. Look at this. We are dropping quick.
All right. The gates are opening.
The boat side tied to us.
All right, the gates are getting ready to open. You have a building up here. I don't know what it is, but there's people on almost every floor watching us go through.
Yeah, we've already dropped about 10 feet. That tanker's behind us again.
Okay, the gates opened up, and we're going to the next one. It's our last gate, our lock. That opens up. We are in the Pacific Ocean, baby. Right there. What a journey none of us will ever forget. Okay. Last gates are opening up. We're going through. And there is the Pacific Ocean.
Green, but we are here. We have arrived. So we've made it through the canal to the Pacific side. We are about to go through the Bridge of the Americas. And then we're gonna take a mooring and go shopping and reprovision before we go to the Pearls. Fish on, fish on. So you know, if you don't like that reel, you bought it for Jonathan for Christmas a couple years ago.
Papa's on it.
I'm ready. First fish in the Pacific.
Yeah, the first fish in the Pacific.
Woo! Peggy, you remember that pink feather that you thought was ugly?
Yeah. That is what we caught.
Oh, it's a nice fish.
Yeah, it's a nice fish.
Oh, yeah.
Very nice.
Tuna!
Right next to him.
No way.
Follower, drop
it right there.
Baby, drop that other line back.
Matt, or David, you want to do it? Oh my God, he's beautiful, babe. Yeah, I think we want him.
Yeah?
Fish.
Woo!
Okay, hon. Do you want to open that cooler, please?
Fish on, fish on! Number two.
Why?
Oh.
Dude, that's sushi.
That's
sushi
totally sushi
right there.
Size.
No, we're eating that sushi.
We're keeping that guy.
We're having surf and turf tonight.
Fish on, fish on. Fish number three today. So far we've got two tunas.
I got a famous skipjack.
Daddy O is bringing in another. We think it might be another tuna, another skipjack. We got a huge jack. Yeah, Daddy O. Oh my gosh. My favorite.
That's a nice fish.
What color is it? What kind of fish is it?
It's a jack.
It's like a yellowtail.
Oh! He's huge!
John, you need to
play. No, no.
Come on, yeah, David, perfect spot.
Holy
shit. Hold that up. Let me see this guy compared to the body of you guys. He's huge! All right, Jonathan just took a mooring for the dinghy and he's swimming into me. Because we've got 14-foot tides here. A la Cantadora. We're gonna go spend the day exploring. Well, we're exploring Cantadora on this rickety old little golf cart. Mr. Toad's Wild Ride. And we just found this abandoned...
I think it's a Club Med.
I doubt it. Abandoned hotel, and it's gorgeous here.
Resort.
It's falling apart, this resort, but it's absolutely beautiful here. Look at this beach. There's a ferry beached on shore and all tore up.
Hey, they got guys rebuilding it right now.
Really? Well, apparently there's somebody rebuilding it. Well, that's cool. Hi. Well, it has been an awesome week in Panama. We went through the canal. We went to the Pearl Islands with my family, with my parents, and got to explore the Pearl Islands a bit. And then we came back and explored the city a bit, which you can see right here in the distance. It's just absolutely gorgeous. And all in all, it was a really great visit. I'm happy that we stopped and saw Panama, and today we're saying goodbye to Panama and sailing, well, at least Panama City, and we're sailing all the way up to the very border between Panama and Costa Rica, which will take us 2 days. And then we sail from there. We're probably gonna jump off and sail straight to Mexico as long as the wind provides, you know, the right direction, so. Yeah, we've got a long journey ahead of us, 3,000 more miles till we hit San Diego and take a break. So it should be fun. Should be a lot of hard work and exhausting, but we can do it in probably 3 weeks straight. So we're hoping to stop a couple of times we have to for fuel, but otherwise we're excited and it's time to go. We're off. So
forward,
yeah, goodbye Panama. Hello, Costa Rica. Jonathan. If you enjoyed watching this video and want to experience an adventure of your own, go to gypsywindcharters.com and book your next adventure with us in Alaska.